Welcome to Fearless Friday. You've been out there for days, weeks, months, and you're trying to approach girls, but you're not having any success. You're getting rejected left and right. Girls are not giving you their number. And if they are, they're not texting you back, or they're not being receptive to your advances to set up a date and meet up later. So you're probably like, yo, when is this going to turn over? And when am I going to get very consistent at getting the girls that I want? And I know that can be a very frustrating thing. I remember being out there for days on end and feeling like this is never going to work. Like, what's the point? I'm getting rejected left and right. No girls are giving me the numbers. The ones that I do get, nobody's texting me back. And it's really starting to take a shot to my self-esteem. And if I was being frankly honest. And so I get this from a lot of clients, especially clients I talk to on the phone. They're like, oh, you know, I've been out approaching for like the last 3 or 4 years. And I'm like, okay, cool. How many girls do you go on dates with per week or per month or a year? And they're like, ah, yeah, that's the funny thing. I haven't met a girl, I haven't gone on a date. And I'm like, yeah, you've been approaching all these years. You've been approaching 3 or 4 years and you haven't gotten a date. There's something going on there, right? And I can identify with that because I know what it's like to go out and to just shoot in the dark and hope that you're going to get some success in it. So the topic of the video today is approaching a numbers game, because I know it can feel like a numbers game. So to answer that question, it's yes, but it's also no. And I'll get into that a little bit further in the video. But just know that as you are learning how to develop your skill of grounding, containing, leading, connecting, that what you thought was a numbers game actually ends up becoming a non-numbers game. What I mean by that is that what you thought was a numbers game actually isn't a numbers game. And that you can go out and effectively talk to the first girl of the day, and that'll be the girl's number that you get. That'll be the date that you have for that night. That'll be the girl that's down to go to your house and hang out and hook up or just go on an insta date with, right? So we're gonna talk about that a little bit more in the video. Now, what I see most commonly in guys who are not getting the success that they want is that they're doing the same thing over and over. Like, they're reactive, which is the opposite of being grounded. And a lot of guys are not grounded. A lot of guys are way up here in their head. A lot of guys are spraying their energy everywhere versus sending it straight down the bodies of the legs, relaxing, having a well-connected interaction with the girl so he can feel her and she can feel him. A lot of guys aren't doing that. What they're doing is they're letting that energy in their body build up. And then they start moving around, fidgeting, touching their face, messing with their hands, got their hands in their pocket. They just don't know what to do with themselves, right? They're moving their legs around, and what they're doing is they're just dissipating all that tension, which can be used for connection. I don't know if you guys ever heard Brian say it, but the water hose, this is an analogy. The water hose is the tension. The water that comes through the hose itself is the connection, right? So you can't have connection without there being tension. We talk about eye contact a lot, and why we use eye contact when we're doing model work here with the guys and the girls is because feelings are felt through the eye contact. And a lot of guys, unfortunately, are blocking off any access to feeling. They don't want to be seen feeling. They don't want to be seen having vulnerable emotions show up by women because they're the fear of being judged, the fear of being made fun of, the fear of being appearing weak. They don't want to show a girl that they might have some sadness on the inside. They don't want to show a girl that they have some lust that they want to have sex with them. They don't want to show girls that they've got anger, they're frustrated, they may have had a crappy day, or they're not doing well out there with their approaches, right? So they don't want to show that stuff and express that stuff. So what do? They find ways to block it and wall off, which is diverting from eye contact and avoiding all the feelings that are going on in their body. This is one of the number one things that kills interactions. And it was doing it a lot for me earlier on too. So these are the common things that I see with guys who are struggling with getting results. They're avoiding tension, they're not grounding themselves, and they're really just ultimately not allowing themselves to be seen, and they're also not receiving really well. So anyways, before we hop into that, I remember how detrimental it was to my success when it came to watching Brian's videos over and over and over. So I used to work at the library, right? And I used to have my headphones in whenever I was shelving books. And I would just have Brian's videos on repeat. So even though I wasn't watching him, I was listening to him in the background. So all this information that he was giving was just coming to my subconscious over and over and over. until I met him and did a workshop. But even still, after the workshops were over, I would still listen to him over and over. Or I would even listen to the lectures that I recorded during the workshops and just listen to them over and over on my drive to work. So I know how important or powerful it actually is to have that stuff running in the background so that your subconscious picks up on the topics. So again, this brings me to my point. Hitting like and subscribe is not really just for us, but it's really for you, because what you're doing is you're getting hit with these videos constantly on topics that actually matter to you, so that you guys can learn how to master these topics, master being grounded, master connecting, opening up your heart, filling your stomach, your self-esteem, filling your turn on and expressing it with a woman, right? Learn how to receive, learn how to release even. We teach so many different things here that are all fundamental to having great interactions and drawing women in. So when we ask you to hit like and subscribe, it's really for you. Because again, I know how powerful it is to let stuff run in the background, and I still constantly watch Brian's videos or listen to them in the background because they're either reminding me of something I might have forgotten, or they're presenting something to me that I haven't mastered yet, and I'm like anxious or really wanting to get to that level. So consider subscribing if you guys really want to get good at this stuff. Let your subconscious really take over in the background, because it will, even if you're not conscious of it, the stuff will start seeping in little by little. And when you guys find yourself in front of a woman, you're like, damn, how did I just do that? And I didn't even think of it. It just happened. Well, it's because you've been priming your mind. You've been priming the pump, and it's been going into your subconscious, and it's starting to become, Brian calls it unconscious competence, which is you're starting to do this stuff without even thinking about it. And it's just becoming a part of your ultimate being without you having to force it or shove it down. Okay. So hit the like, subscribe button so you can level up. Now, let's go ahead and jump into the topic here. Why do I say yes, approaching is a numbers game? Well, it's true. If you haven't cultivated the skill of learning how to ground yourself, if you haven't cultivated the skill of learning how to run energy through your body and down your body, especially nervous, anxious energy that's wanting to shoot up, that's wanting to make you get reactive in your body, that's wanting to make you put your hands in your pocket, put your hands behind your back like this, and all these different types of things and the ways that we're doing or moving in order to move out of the tension, then a lot of your interactions are going to go south. You're going to get rejected a lot. And that's just the nature of it, because women are not attracted to reactive guys. So in order to clean that up, you have to go out and intentionally practice being grounded, and intentionally practice playing with the energy in your body. Can you take that energy and ground it through your legs? Can you feel the feet beneath you on the ground? What are you doing with the emotions that are just kind of going everywhere in your body? Are you grounding them out, or are you being reactive to them? And also, are you connecting, right? Are you touching? Are you leading? And it's very hard to do a lot of this stuff if you haven't learned the basics, the fundamentals of the grounding. We got a ton of videos on grounding, so go ahead and check our channel out. Look for the videos that have grounding in the title. Watch them, listen to them in the background. Let them really teach you what we mean by grounding, because I know it can feel like a very esoteric thing, but it's really not at the end of the day. So if you haven't gotten this stuff down and you're going out and approaching, you might approach, I don't know, 50, 60 girls and not get one number, or you may get one number, but still that's not really success when you could be getting way more, right? And so it can be very frustrating being out there. That's why I say, yes, it is a numbers game when you haven't cultivated the skills yet. You might find yourself out there full days and you're not getting any results that are significant enough to be proud of, right? So yes, it's gonna be a numbers game. And what is a numbers game really, right? That means, well, maybe you go out and approach 100 girls and one of those 100 girls by statistics has to be interested in you just by sheer number or volume of people that you've approached and stopped. Somebody's got to connect with you. Somebody's got to be open to you at some point. Now, let's flip to the other side of that. Why do I say approaching is not a numbers game? Well, I'll say it like this, because when you have the skill and you're grounded and you're proactive and you're transferring energy between you and the woman, you're connecting to the eyes, you have tension there, there's energy flowing, you're smiling, she's smiling, you're feeling her in your body, she's feeling you in her body, you're affecting her, she's affecting you, you start to realize that you might go out and approach the first girl of the day and boom, that's the one you hit it off with right away. You get the number, she's excited to talk to you, she's not doing anything all of a sudden, and maybe you guys go out on an insta date, maybe you get her number, you guys set up a date for later. Now, this starts happening very frequently, almost every day if you're very persistent with it, right? And so in that sense, it's not a numbers game. You can literally go out and meet the first girl and make it happen. And that starts to become the norm for you over time. So you almost develop this expectation that if I go out and put myself in a venue where there are a lot of women, I know I'm going to talk to girls at some point. Even if it's not the first cute girl I see or the first couple girls that I see, I'm going to talk to some girl here at some point because I have a tendency to attract women, and that becomes your new norm. Now, again, for me, it wasn't always like that, especially earlier on, man. I can tell you how bad I was with it, how much I would avoid women, how much that having a conversation would make me shake and make me nervous and make me essentially just want to pull out of there as soon as I could, and how much that was really messing up the success that I was having. Where I'm at now, where I can go out and just be in the venue for maybe 2 or 3 minutes and I'll see a girl I want to go talk to, and I'll walk over there and trade talk to her because I'm not scared, my body's not freaking out anymore. And if it is a girl of a higher caliber, quote unquote higher caliber, that's very subjective, my body might get a little bit nervous because I have a story around this type of girl. But within a couple seconds of talking to her, it'll just drop down. I'll feel my body, I'll feel my legs, I'll feel my feet, I'll ground, I'll connect, I'll lead. Because it's very hard to do all that stuff. It's very hard to connect, ground, lead, and really be masculine when you have all this anxiety running in the background that's distracting you from being your most solid self. So the minute you can learn how to ground that out, you start to realize that, oh, these skills, these leadership skills, escalation, moving things forward, going for the kiss, especially touching, reaching out, you already have those skills in you once all the static calms down. So again, it's not a numbers game when you haven't mastered, but yes, at the beginning of it, when you're learning, it's going to be a numbers game. But again, it doesn't have to take that long in order for you to get to it being a numbers game, to it being very regular and very common for you to get a girl's number, the first girl of the day, the first girl you meet, girls just walking down the street, or just find yourself in a place where you didn't even intend to go talk to a girl that day, but all of a sudden you're getting a number just because that's becoming your, just becoming more of your part of your normal reality. Okay. So anyways, guys, I hope this video helped you guys out. And, if you guys do find yourselves out there playing the numbers game, then there's something that you don't understand, that on a core level that you don't understand. Maybe you understand it logically, but you don't understand it in the body, or else you'd be doing it the right way. So if you need help with this stuff, let's hop on the phone. I love chatting with guys about where they are, finding out where they're trying to get to, how we can help them, and ultimately just kind of setting up a plan for them to move forward. So if this is you and you want to hop on a call, go ahead and email me. It should be down here on the screen. And let's set up a call and chat for a little bit, okay? If you have any more questions or you have videos that you actually want to see us shoot that are particular to what you're dealing with, go ahead and put it in the comments below, because we love knowing what we're going to shoot next, especially if we know it's going to help a guy or a bunch of guys or all guys. All right. Enjoy shooting this video for you guys. And remember, only the confident really live. Peace.